in me. You are the seed by faith receive the blessing of Abraham. Wherever you are, where you go, whatever you touch is anointed to grow. You are the seed by faith receive the blessing of Abraham. I would just remind you. You are the seed by faith receive the blessing of Abraham. Kingdom people, don't worry about where we are in time right now. God's got you so covered.
Is a journey, not a destination. There are no mistakes, just chances we've taken. Lay down your regrets, 'cause all we have is now. Wake up in the morning and get out of bed. Start making a mental list in my head of all of the things. Oh,
Good morning, everybody. It's so good to see everybody, to be a part of our first virtual women's conference here at Zion Missionary Baptist Church. My name is Dr. Robert James, and this is my lovely wife, Lady Penda James, and we're so grateful for all of you joining us today here for the conference. I know that it's going to be a great experience for you. And so what I ask you to do is make sure you disconnect from what's going on around you and connect and be intentional about spending this time together in workshops and sessions, just to make sure that you have an encounter with Jesus Christ to understand the power of spoken blessings. I know that my friend, Dr. Hale, is going to bless us. I know the other presenters are going to bless us. And I guess I'm also a little biased. My wife's session is going to bless you too. So my wife is going to share some things with you today, just from her heart, and bring some greetings as well.
Hi, everybody. As Pastor said, I am Lady Penda James, and we extend our heartfelt greetings to you this morning. We want to share with you our love and our gratitude. Thank you for sharing with us in Zion's first virtual women's conference. Welcome home. Home is the place where you can let your hair down, you can relax, you can be yourself, you can be with your friends, sit at God's feet, and be restored. Welcome. Thank you so much to everybody behind the scenes who put this together. And now we want you all to dig right in and feel the power of spoken blessings.
And like my wife said, make sure that today that you dig in today. I'm so grateful for the team that has put this on. Thank you, Sister Boggs, and your ministry team for just making this virtual experience possible. And also, anytime I can get an opportunity, I want to remind every one of you who are out there watching us this morning, make sure you take time to go out and vote early. Thank you so much for joining us. I know it will be a blessing. I was in the session yesterday a little bit. I snuck in, but I must try to sneak in a little bit on the session today. So I know that you're going to enjoy yourselves today. God bless you. We love you, and enjoy your time here at our virtual women's conference. Thank you.
Welcome again, every one of you, for joining us for the Zion Missionary Baptist Church 2020 Virtual Women's Conference, The Power of Spoken Blessings. I am LaVeda Boggs, your host for today and the leader of the Women's Ministry, who is sponsoring this awesome event for you this weekend. It is a privilege to be with you, and we thank you for devoting some of your precious time to be with us in worship and prayer this weekend. We have planned prayer, laughter, prayer, worship, prayer, singing, and so we want you to just sit back and say hallelujah, amen, and be blessed. Last night, we focused on service and the giving of blessing bags to the Whitworth Women's Facility in conjunction with our women's prison ministry. If you weren't there, well, you missed something. Today, however, is chocked full of varied things for you to enjoy. We have preaching, teaching, training, singing, worship, praying, and so much more. We also have a lot of giveaways and prizes to be awarded throughout the day. It's just another small way for us to say thank you, and we want to bless you. We don't want you to miss any of today's offering. We want you to be fully engaged, fully aligned, fully invested. So what I want you to do right now is to find your chat button. We want to hear from you. So tell us who you are, tell us where you're from, and meet some of the other ladies who are in attendance this morning. We also want you to know that if you would like prayer, you can post it in the private section of the chat box, or you can contact us at 706-701-2590. And someone will be in touch with you. Additionally, we will add your prayer requests to our traveling women's prayer box. So we do want to hear from you if needed. You all have received an online program booklet, so mark your spots where you need to be throughout the day. And that way you'll be able to move quickly from session to session. So let's get started with prayer by Mother Odine Allen.
Dear Heavenly Father, we enter your gates with thanksgiving and we enter your courts with praise. We thank you, dear God, for your goodness and we praise you for your greatness. We come, dear Heavenly Father, this morning, thanking you for the opportunity to offer prayer for this Women's Weekend. We pray for your blessings and your guidance on all that will be said and all that will be done. We pray, dear Heavenly Father, that it will be for your glory and for your benefit and for your kingdom. Dear Heavenly Father, we pray for the anointing of the Holy Spirit to fall fresh on the speakers, that they might share a word that caused lives to be changed and relationships to be restored. We pray for the leaders of the group session for wisdom and clarity. We pray for your blessings on all who are in attendance. We pray, dear Heavenly Father, for their families and their households. We pray for forgiveness of our sins, Lord. And we pray, Father, that you do not hold our sins against us. We thank you that we have redemption and forgiveness of sins through the blood of Jesus Christ. We pray for your continued guidance and blessings and protection as we continue to love you and as we continue to serve you. In Jesus' name and for his name's sake, amen.
Clap your hands, do your dance. Keynote speaker. Reverend Dr. Cynthia L. Hale is the founder and senior pastor of the Ray of Hope Christian Church in Decatur, Georgia. She's a native of Roanoke, Virginia. Dr. Hale received a Bachelor of Arts in Music from Hollins University, a Master of Divinity degree from Duke University, and a Doctor of Ministry degree from United Theological Seminary. She holds not one but five honorary doctorates of divinity and an honorary doctor of law degree. As a woman of vision, Dr. Hale is revered worldwide for her leadership, integrity, and compassion. Her vision and leadership led her to establish not one but two ministries, ELAW Pastoral Ministries Incorporated and the Women in Ministry Conference Incorporated. Now, ELAW is a mentoring program to assist in the spiritual and practical development of pastors and parachurch leaders. And the Women in Ministry Conference is a premier national conference with a focused mission to develop, coach, and mentor Christian women in ministry for the 21st century. As a recipient of numerous honors and recognitions, Dr. Hale was inducted into the African American Biographies Hall of Fame, the Martin Luther King Jr. Board of Preachers of Morehouse College, and the Atlanta Business League Women's Hall of Fame. She is a recipient of the National Urban Leeds Women of Power Award and Preston Taylor Living Legacy Award, the Balm in Gilead Keeper of the Flame Award, and she was recognized on Ebony Magazine's Power 100 list as one of the nation's most influential African American leaders. In 2009, Dr. Hale was appointed by President Barack Obama to serve on the President's Commission on White House Fellowships. She also served as a member of the 2016 Platform Committee for the Democratic National Convention and delivered the invocation at the 2016 Democratic National Convention in Philadelphia. Dr. Hale is a contributing writer for many books and publications, including Power in the Pulpit 2, How America's Most Effective Black Preachers Prepare Their Sermons, and the Preaching Resource Series, Feasting on the Gospels. In January 2010, she authored her first book entitled, I'm a Piece of Work, Sister Shaped by God. Dr. Hale presently serves as the chairperson of the IC3 board, chairperson of the Board of Trustees of Beulah Heights University, and member of the Board of Visitors of the Divinity School at Duke University, a member of the Board of Trustees at Hollins University, and the Vice President for the Hampton University Ministers Conference. Dr. Hale is an active lifetime member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated. She currently serves as the co-chairperson of the International Spiritual Oversight Committee and the chairperson of the membership committee of her local chapter, New Lambda Omega Chapter. During her 41 years of ministry, her ministerial gift has drawn thousands, young and old, to witness the anointing of a woman totally sold out for the kingdom of God. We too will now join the thousands who have sat at the feet of Dr. Hale to hear an amazing word from God. Please enjoy.
I was a federal prison chaplain in an all-male prison. And God began to speak to me and help me to understand that he would give me my own church. I didn't see that because women weren't called to pastor churches, but God promised and I accepted his promise and began to move on that. So the Christian Church Disciples of Christ, my denomination, called me and asked me if I'd be interested in interviewing to start a church. That was 31 years ago. I interviewed, I got accepted. They paid my salary for 2 years. I came here to, first to Lithonia, Georgia, where I started the church in my apartment with four people meeting. And
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and welcome Reverend Dr. Cynthia Hale, Senior Pastor, Ray of Hope Christian Church, to lead the invocation.
Pray with me. Prayer will not only heal your broken heart, it will heal your broken relationships. Prayer will make you take a serious look at yourself, not just the folks that you are praying with and for. Prayer makes us confront our anger, our arrogance, and pride. Prayer will make us deal with our bitterness, jealousy, hurt, and unforgiveness. Prayer will make us confess our wrong, our prejudice, and our lack of trust and lack of love. Prayer will change you. Richard Foster says, if you don't want to change, don't pray. Prayer will make you love your enemy and those you would rather not have anything to do with. Prayer will reconcile your marriage and make you speak to that booger that you're not speaking to. Prayer will bring your family back together, overcome your differences, friends and colleagues and sisters in Christ. Prayer will make you speak even when you don't want to speak. Prayer will make you open your mouth. Prayer will make you say something nice to that person that you haven't spoken to in years. You can't pray with folks and then not speak to them. You can't pray with me and then walk by me. You can't pray for me and then not love me. Wholeness is not having to apologize any longer for being who you are and knowing what you know and handling your business and not have to say to folks, excuse me, excuse me. You don't have to apologize for being black in America, for being a man, for being a woman, for being intelligent, for being able to handle it. That's what it means to be whole. They left their homes, the comfortable, the secure, to follow Jesus. And Luke says they used their own resources. That's their own money. Hallelujah. To support the men. Come on here and give God some praise up in here for women who got their own resources.
Thank you. Reverend Robert James and First Lady Penda James, Sister Laveda Boggs, Women's Ministry Chair, and the beautiful and blessed women of the Zion Missionary Baptist Church Women's Ministry. What a joy it is for me to be here with you this morning, even virtually for your conference. Thank you, Sister Boggs, for your gracious invitation. Your theme scripture is number 6, 23:2-27. And I'm reading from the New International Version. The Lord said to Moses, "Tell Aaron and his sons, this is how you are to bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. So they will put my name on the Israelites and I will bless them. For just a few moments, I want to speak to you from the topic, the power of spoken blessings. The power of spoken blessings. God, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our beautiful hearts be found acceptable in thy sight. Oh God, speak to us today so that we might learn how to speak blessing into the lives of others. Oh God, I pray that in the next few moments I would decrease and you would increase so that the people will hear none of me, but all of you. I pray this in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus. Amen. People often say to me as they are leaving my presence, whenever they are about to depart, they will say, have a blessed day or be blessed. It could be a family member or friend, a bank teller, grocery store clerk, food service provider, a nurse or a doctor, a stranger in the street, or a sister or brother in Christ. I've heard these words come across the lips of some of the most unlikely individuals. Like a week ago, when the guy who was preparing to prepare or fix my mother's roof said to me, have a blessed day. It doesn't matter who says it. Every time I hear it, something stirs down deep inside of me and gives a boost to my spirit. To have someone bless our day and our lives is what we all long for and desperately need. Life is tough. We live in a world where too often what is spoken to us is negative and discouraging. We hear insults and criticism and words that wound us. And so to hear someone speak blessing into our lives is food for our weary souls. But I must admit that given the fact that so many people are saying have a blessed day, I wonder if it has become cliche. Is it just something we say because we've heard others say it? Or are we being intentional in our blessing of others? Do folks even understand what it means to bless and be blessed? Do those who say the words understand the power they have to bestow blessing on the one who is receiving it? The word bless in the Hebrew is barak, and it means to bless, salute, congratulate, thank, and praise. A blessing is given as an act of declaring or wishing favor and goodness upon another. Though blessing is a broad term, it has a quite specific content in the Old Testament. God blesses his people by giving them children, property, land, good health, and his presence. A blessing is not only the good effect of words given to encourage the receiver, but it has the power to bring to pass whatever is spoken. The ancient Israelites attributed unusual power to the spoken word. They understood that once it is uttered, it takes on a life of its own and continues in effect whether or not conditions change or the original speaker had a change of mind and heart. In the Old Testament, what we find is that leaders often pronounce blessings on their people. Moses blessed Israel and David blessed the people during his reign when the Ark of the Covenant was brought back to Jerusalem with singing and dancing. Parents bless their children and their children's children, especially when they were about to depart in death. As I just told you, even if the blessing was spoken by mistake, as was the case with Isaac when Jacob deceived him into believing that he was Esau, it could not be taken back. The ancients understood far better than we do the power of spoken blessings. They are permanent. The priest Eli pronounced a blessing over the barren Hannah after hearing her agonizing prayer for a child. The priestly blessing was quickly fulfilled by the Lord. After Hannah and her husband Elkanah dedicated Samuel to service in the sanctuary, the priest Eli blessed them with the invocation for additional children, and immediately God fulfilled their blessing. And babies just started coming one right after another. There are numerous stories of blessing by the people of God on others that were fulfilled in the scripture, given evidence of the power of the spoken word. But one dare not think that the blessings came from humans. We are merely instruments in the hand of God, tools used to convey God's favor, God's goodness, God's grace on the lives of others. When we speak blessing into the lives of others through greeting, proclamation, or prayer, we release God's favor, God's goodness, and power into their lives to meet the situations they are facing. God uses our blessing to do in the lives of others what he purposes and plans us to do. That's what intercessory prayer is all about. Prayer is working in partnership with God. Prayer is agreeing with God and speaking in faith that which God wants to do in the life of those we are praying for. Prayer is releasing God to do it. God is the ultimate source of blessing. Nobody can bless you like God can. God is the source of all blessings. This is made clear in the doxology that we often sing. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. All of our blessings flow from God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, the Trinity. God is the one who gives us the capacity to live a full and free life. This is his desire for you and for me and for everyone. You may look back over your life and wonder if what you're experiencing is all there is. There have been so many rough places in your life, so many heartaches, so much pain that you can't imagine that there is anything beyond where you are right now. But if you are in Christ today, I speak this blessing over your life. I declare to you in the name of Jesus that your pain and where you are right now is not your destiny. God has more for you. That's what Jesus meant when he said in John 10:10, I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. That's the way we're used to hearing it in the King James Version. But the NIV says, have it to the full. God has already blessed you with the capacity to have a full life, a life that is more than you ever imagined it could be. To be blessed by God is the essential ingredient for a successful and satisfying life, a life with meaning, a life with joy, a life where you can dance to the tune of it without missing a beat. That's what God wants for all of us. The equivalent to Barak is the Greek word for bless, is eulogy or eulogize, from you, good, and logos, speech or word. It is to speak well of, to praise, to extol, to bless abundantly, like I just used it, to evoke a blessing on, to give thanks. Eulogia or blessings can be from humans to God, like the psalmist David did when he said in Psalms 34:1-3, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. Oh, magnify with me. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt God's name together. David was running for his life. Saul was pursuing him to kill him. And he ran into King Abimelech, who would have killed him also. But even though David found himself in a difficult place, he said, I will bless the Lord. I will speak well of. I will praise. I'll give thanks. I will extol Behold the Lord. Hallelujah. Can I tell you that when you bless the Lord, no matter what is going on in your life, we confuse the enemy. We tie his hands. He doesn't know what to do with a woman who is dancing through her darkness and prancing through her pain, praising and giving God the glory that he is so worthy of. The psalmist also reminds us, when the praises go up, the blessings come down. Eulogia, or blessing, can be from person to person and from God to his people. When God blesses us, he fills our lives with unlimited benefits. He has done that most profoundly in Jesus Christ. Well, God is the source of our blessing. Jesus is the resource of our blessings. When he came to earth, he came blessing us by everything he said and everything he did. He spoke life to a little girl that was dead, saying, "Talitha kama," little girl, get up. And she got up. He told the man who had been lying by the pool of Bethesda 38 years, take up your bed and walk. And the man got up, took up his bed and walked. God's word spoken becomes the enablement for us to do what it says. As Jesus launched his ministry on earth, both his words and actions were a stream of blessing, like nothing we've never heard before. In the opening of his Sermon on the Mount, he spoke blessings into the lives of people to meet their every condition and need, making promises such as, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons and daughters of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of God. What Jesus is saying is, oh, the blessedness of how happy, satisfied, fulfilled in life are those who receive blessings as a reward for the life they live. By his life and death, Jesus came to earth to provide God's blessing for our lives. It is the Apostle Paul who made this clear to us in his letter to the saints in Ephesus. Go with me there in your Bibles. I'm going to read Ephesians, the first chapter, verses 3 through 14. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. For he chose us in him before the foundation, the creation of the world, to be holy and blameless in his sight. In love, he predestined us for adoption to sonship through Jesus Christ, in accordance with his pleasure and will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he has freely given us in the one he loves. In him, we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, in accordance with the riches of God's grace that he lavished on us with all wisdom and understanding. He made known to us the mystery of his will according to his good pleasure, which he purposed in Christ to put into full effect when the times reach their fulfillment, to bring unity to all things in heaven and on earth under Christ. In him we were chosen, having been predestined according to the plan of him who works out everything in accordance with the purpose of his will, in order that we who were the first to hope in Christ might be for the praise of his glory. And you were also included in Christ when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation. When you believed, you were marked in him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit, who is a deposit guaranteeing our inheritance until the redemption of those who are God's possession, to the praise of his glory. My sisters, what Paul has done is made clear that God has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in Christ Jesus. The Greek word that Paul uses for to bless means to benefit or to prosper us. Everything God has done is to benefit us. He did it to prosper or enrich our lives, to ensure our success in life and living. Paul's use of the past tense participle, has blessed, points to the fact that the blessing occurred in eternity past. God's decision to bless us was made in eternity, before time and before creation. When God says, I've loved you with an everlasting love, we think only of the fact that he will love us forever in the future. But he loved us and had us on his mind, put a plan in place to bless us long before time began. God wasn't stingy with his blessings. He didn't give us a half a blessing or a few choice blessings. He gave us every spiritual blessing. Do you understand that? And the blessings are spiritual in nature, not material, heavenly, nor earthly. They will not wear out, rust, corrode, or rot. They cannot be stolen, lost, misplaced, or dispossessed. Like the earthly things we clamor for, long for, hang on to for security, rather than resting securely in him. Not realizing that God has already given us that which is greater. These blessings are eternal, not temporal. They're unlimited. Say unlimited. They will not run out. You can't use them up. God's blessings will not expire on you. You don't have to use them before a certain date or have them renewed. Since these blessings have already been bestowed on us in Jesus Christ, which means that they were available to us at the new birth, we don't have to pray or ask for them. We just need to receive them and appropriate them by faith. All that God has blessed us with is already ours. We are to enter into the enjoyment of our provision. After telling us that we are blessed, Paul goes on to list the blessings, the benefits with which God has enriched our lives. Each blessing is an affirmation of who we are. I want you to get this, because when we start blessing others, each affirmation we make to them, each blessing needs to affirm, support, encourage who they are, even before they start acting like it. Hallelujah. Every blessing has been provided to us through the works of the three persons of the Trinity, through the selection or election of the Father, the sacrifice of the Son, and the seal of the Spirit. It all begins with the election of the Father, who Paul says in verse 4, he chose us in him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in his sight. The first blessing that God gave us in Christ is that he chose us. All of us have experienced times in our lives when we were not chosen for a job we needed, a promotion we wanted, a sorority or other social service or civic club we wanted to be a part of. Some of you, like me, have not been chosen to be someone's wife. And when you are not chosen, it can make you feel unwanted or unworthy. But God chose us before the creation of the world, before the world was made, before there was a when or where, before God stepped out on space and spoke the world into being, he chose us. Before any person, job, organization, or whatever failed to choose you, God had already chosen you. How dare we allow anyone to make us feel rejected when we've already been chosen? Say, I'm chosen. God chose us to be his treasured possession. We were chosen for a special purpose. He chose us not for privilege, not to be snooty, not to stick our nose in the air and look down at others. We were chosen by the sovereignty of God for salvation. God's salvation is God's initiation, God's doing, not ours. We're saved by grace through faith. It is a gift of God so that no one can boast. And when we accept him by faith, we are justified by faith, and the blessings of Abraham, hallelujah, are ours. He chose us for service. Our salvation is the means by which he intends to redeem the world. He picked us out of a crowd so he can send us back into the crowd to show and tell what he has done for us. He chose us in Christ. It's because of what Christ did for us. He chose us that we might be holy and blameless in his sight. The word holy means set apart, to be different. God chooses us to be different. He blessed us to be different, not like everybody else. We were chosen to represent him in the world, which means that we ought to look, talk, act, and bless others like him. When people see us, they should say, "Baby, you look just like your daddy." The problem with us is that we don't want to be different. We would rather conform than be transformed. We don't want to stand out in the crowd, despite the fact that we were picked out of the crowd. We want the favor, but we don't want to be seen as God's favorite. We want to fit in. But when you're blessed, you can't hide it. You can't deny it. Say, "I'm blessed." Say, "I'm blessed." We've been blessed to be a blessing in others' lives. God chose us, and in love, he predestined us. He actually chose us by predestinating us. He determined beforehand that he would adopt us to be his daughters, giving us the same rights and privileges as natural born ones. We are co-heirs with Christ of all that God owns. We've been blessed by the selection of the Father. We've been blessed by the sacrifice of the Son. In him, we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sin, in accordance with the riches of God's grace, which he lavished on us. It was because of the sacrifice of the Son, the grace was given to us. The fact that he shed his blood, that we have been redeemed or brought out of slavery to sin and its penalty, because of his death, we have been forgiven of every sin, past, present, and future. We no longer have to feel guilty when we've done something wrong. We no longer have to look over our shoulders and wonder if God is coming to get us. God is not petty like the people who we have in our lives and like we can be at times. God is not coming after you. God wants you to confess, and when you confess, you are forgiven. And your sins are removed as far as the east is from the west. You are forgiven. You no longer have to live in guilt and shame. God, Christ died to set us free. He took our place. He became sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be the righteousness of God in him. Don't you know that an exchange has taken place? He took our sins and gave us his righteousness. And when God looks at us, hallelujah, you talking about being blessed. When I think about who I am, who I was before Christ, oh, all of us could have this testimony. All of us do have this testimony. If people really knew who we were and who we are right now, they wouldn't like us, much less sit next to us. It's a good thing we on Zoom. But the reality is, God in his grace rain down grace upon us. It wasn't an afternoon shower. It was a downpour. God is generous in his grace, his unmerited favor. And then the Son enlightened us. Living in this world with all that is going on could keep us uptight and on edge, not knowing what to do most of the time. But through the Son, we have been blessed with wisdom and understanding. Wisdom is the knowledge of things both human and divine. It's the answer to the eternal problems of life and death. God and humans and time and eternity. To have wisdom is to understand life Oh my God, if you're sitting next to someone or anyone in the house with you, look at them and say, I'm blessed with wisdom and understanding. To have wisdom is to understand life from God's perspective. We have been blessed with the mind of Christ. He has given us the intellectual knowledge and ability to think great thoughts, as well as the practical knowledge to handle the day-to-day challenges. We don't have to live in fear, live in uncertainty, wondering what in the world is going to happen next, especially after this election. There is a certain completeness in the blessings we receive from God. He gives us everything we need for life and living. We don't lack anything that we need to live life abundantly and successfully. We have been blessed by the selection of the Father. We've been blessed by the sacrifice of the Son. We've been blessed by the sealing of the Spirit. The third and final area of spiritual blessing is ours through the third person of the Trinity, the Holy Spirit. Can I just say that all of the blessings that God gives to us are mediated to us through the Holy Spirit, who lives in us. And He has sealed us, making us spiritually secure. He's marked us with a seal, huh? A seal is a validation of ownership. It indicates that we belong to God. God seals or marks His children with the Holy Spirit, indicating that we are His treasured possession. The seal is a sign of authenticity, indicating that we are His authentic spiritual children, not fakes or imposters. He has put His mark on us. When I was in seminary, I was interning in a church in Pittsburgh, North Carolina, where the pastor's name was Reverend John Borens. One day, John and I were walking down the streets of Pittsburgh, and a blind man approached us, tapping along with his cane. It was clear that he could not see physically. My pastor friend John spoke to the blind man and asked him how he was doing. The blind man said, "Fine. And who is that preacher with you?" "That's God's preacher." John, my friend, and I looked at one another and said, "What in the world?" And John said to him, "Man, how did you know that this woman is a preacher?" And the blind man responded, "I see the mark on her. When you got the Holy Ghost, even blind folks can see whose you are and who you are. That acknowledgement of who I am in God, that acknowledgement, that blessing came at just the time I needed it, because I was in seminary with a bunch of men and some women who did not believe that God called women into ministry, and I was struggling, but that blessing changed my heart. It gave me the courage to do what God has called me to do. And I've never been the same again." The seal is a sign that we are covered, protected by God. The Holy Spirit is also given to us as a deposit, a down payment, the first installment, a part given in advance, guaranteeing our inheritance in Christ. All that God has promised us, we will receive in full. The blessings never end. They will last for eternity. So my sisters, it is because we are blessed ourselves that we can be a blessing to others. We are not blessing others out of an empty cup. Our cups runneth over. We are full to the brim of God's blessings, His goodness, His favor. And we are blessed to be a blessing to others. Say, I'm blessed to be a blessing to others. I am blessed just as God has poured into our lives through his Son and his Spirit. We have the privilege and power to actively direct that powerful flow into the hearts and lives of others. We can bless folks in a myriad of ways, but this morning we're talking about spoken blessings. Our spoken blessings flow first of all from the abundance that God has so graciously blessed us with, and his wise and loving intentions to bless us with what is truly our highest good. If we intend to be a blessing to others, this must also be the intentions of our hearts. We must want the highest good for those we seek to bless, even when we don't feel like it. Oh, yes. You know that when somebody has provoked you, when somebody's been ugly to you, when somebody has gotten on your last nerve, when somebody has abandoned or rejected you, when somebody has hurt you deeply and you've carried it for years, unable to forgive them. If you're thinking about blessing them, you need to know that God, through his Holy Spirit living in you, is the one who empowers you to do it, who overwhelms your frustration, your pain, your anger, your provocation to cuss them rather than bless them. By God's Spirit, we are enabled to speak that which he wants to do in their lives. You may not want anything good for them, but God wants it. And so that's why we have to love people. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love forgives and releases the person. We know that the tongue is the organ of speech. The speech that comes from the tongue can be good or evil. How well we know that. We can both bless and curse. Bless God while cussing folk. With this same tongue. The tongue can be a window into the human heart. It pronounces the thoughts and intentions contained in our heart. Oh my God, the tongue is so potent that the writer of Proverbs 18:21 says, it has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. The word power is derived from the Hebrew word yad, meaning an open or extended hand. Life and death are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. The tongue in this verse is depicted as a hand that can literally grab hold of or release something. So the writer of Proverbs is saying, whatever you speak, you are grabbing hold of or you're releasing life or death. The words you speak have the power to release or grab hold of life or death. They're like a seed that when planted develops into a fruit-bearing plant. If we speak blessings, the fruit that is born will be good. But if we speak curses, that is what will be born in another person's life. We know this because unfortunately we do it all the time. If you tell a child that he or she is ugly, stupid, worthless, they will begin to believe that and act that out. If you tell a child you'll never be anything, if you tell a child, I brought you into this world, I'll take you out, even though your mother or father said that to you, that doesn't make it right. But when you tell a child that you love them, that they're handsome, that they're beautiful, that they're wonderful, that they're smart, intelligent, they can do anything, they will believe it and begin to do it. When I was growing up, my father used to call me pretty girl, pretty girl, pretty girl. And I believed him. So I strut around like a pretty girl. But then he said to me, pretty is as pretty does. Whoa! So it wasn't just my strut that said I was pretty. It was my actions. So then I began to live up to the blessing of pretty is as pretty does. What have people said to you that have shaped your life? Some of us have received criticism, comments, and messages from others that has shaped your life in destructive ways. But if you can believe what God says about you, God says that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. You're extraordinary. You're wonderful. You're distinguished. There's nobody like you, not in all the earth. God says that he created you in his image and his likeness. It will begin to cancel the curse and set you free. We must be able to bless ourselves, sisters, if we're going to bless others. When we verbalize a blessing upon others, we have the privilege of channeling God's goodness to others to plant seeds of change in their lives. So the most powerful way to bless others is to bless them with God's words. You can pronounce your blessing, pray your blessing, speak to them what God wants to do in their lives. God has not left us to figure this out all on our own. He's graciously given us a model, a prayer, a blessing to pray over others' lives. He has shown us how to bless people in the words that he spoke to Moses to tell Aaron and his sons. This priestly blessing is a beautiful poetic prayer that God gave the priest to speak into the lives of his people. This is how you should bless the Israelites, God said. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. When we are speaking words of blessing to others, we're actually asking God to bless them. He's the only one who can really bless folks. And just as Aaron and his sons were priests, we are priests as well. 1 Peter 2:9 says, we were a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a people belonging to God, that we may declare the praises of him who called us out of darkness into the marvelous light. The Latin word for priest is pontifex, which talks about a bridge between humans and God. It is through us that God blesses his people. God said to the priest, this is the way you are to bless my people. God is saying to you and I, as his daughters, as his priest, this is the way that you are to bless my people and yours. And he gave them these simple instructions as he established the priesthood in the lives of the people. The priests were blessing them to move from bondage and the wilderness into the promised land. Their destiny. I can't help but make the connection that when we bless people, we are preparing them to cross over from where they are to where God has destined them to be. The priests were to regularly speak these words of blessing to the people. We are to regularly speak words of blessing, speak life to the people. My younger sister was a drug addict for the better part of her life. Every time she would mess up, I would cuss her out. Oh, hear me now. I was so mad, so disappointed in her. I just kept speaking death to her, not life. I was so wrong. the Holy Spirit convicted me finally. Paul makes clear in Ephesians 4:29 that we are not to let any unwholesome talk come out of our mouths, but only that which is good for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. God told me to bless my sister and stop cussing her. And so when she turned 50, I told her, I love you. I love you. I need you. Not to just survive, but thrive. If you keep operating the way that you are operating, you will not survive. God wants you to live and not die. I want you to live and not die. I speak abundance over your life. I speak healing over your life. I speak joy and peace over your life. The Lord bless you. Then I started praying for my sister. That was 13 years ago. And she's been clean ever since. A couple of years ago, she told me that my words to her was when it all started. It made her think about her life and how valuable it is. The priestly blessing is actually a triple blessing. It has a simple three-part structure, each one beginning with the Lord's name. There are some who believe that each part corresponds to one of the three members of the Trinity, just as we saw in Ephesians 1. This time we see the Father as the protector, the Son as the means of grace, and the Holy Spirit as the sustainer of our peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. As you are blessing others, you are speaking His blessing over their lives, that God would provide for their every need and keep, guard, and protect them from all hurt, harm, and danger, to be kept from the evil one. We pray for God to keep people because they have worth and value to us. We keep that which is of a treasure to us in a safe place so that nothing can happen to it. When people are precious to us, then we want God to hold them close and keep them safe and secure from all alarm. Before your husband and children leave the house each day, or if they are still at home, speak blessings over them as they start their day. Pray that God will bless and keep them. If they're having a specific challenge, then pray what the Word says about it over their lives. If your marriage is shaky, if he's mean to you, if you can't forgive him for the things that he has said and done to you, begin to bless him in the name of Jesus. Speak those things that are not as if they were. And watch God work. Speak. The Lord make his face to shine on you. The idea that is being conveyed here is that God's face shining is an expression that refers to an appearance of pleasure and affection equivalent to a smile. When God smiles on us, when God smiles on people, people begin to have joy. It dispels the darkness and deepest gloom. They may be dealing with darkness literally or figuratively, like the dark night of the soul when one is discouraged or fearful or of a bad report from the doctor, a situation on their job that's stressful, the possibility of losing someone near and dear to them. God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. And when he shines his face, when God smiles and is gracious to us, he overwhelms us with his blessing. God is gracious. People need God's favor in their lives. T.D. Jakes says favor ain't fair, but that's what God blesses us with. And that's what we bless others with. Favor, grace, to be lavished. Our speech should always impart grace to others. Your tongue is too sharp. It's not always what you say, but how you say it. You certainly wouldn't want to say to somebody, the Lord bless you and keep you, because you're mad at them, and they know you're mad. But when you're able to speak with grace, the Lord lift up his countenance upon you, is the way that it reads in the King James Version and the way that we are used to hearing it. Lifting up one's countenance means giving one's full visual and mental attention to someone in a favorable way. It's to turn your full attention to that individual. I know we're talking about spoken blessings, but may I suggest that when you give someone your full attention, when you look them in the eyes, that begins to convey warmth and intimacy and affection. It's what we experience when we have to tell somebody something and they look at us, they lean into us, they allow us to see that we have their full attention. That's what we ought to give people when we're speaking to them. The blessing comes not just verbally, but in intangible ways, by the way we look them in the eye. God has his eyes on us. People need to know that God is with them, that they have God's full, undivided attention. And he is giving them his peace. Peace is the final aspect of the priestly blessing. The Hebrew word is shalom. Say shalom. This word embraces more than our English word peace. Shalom involves wholeness and health, serenity, well-being, friendship and harmony with God and others. It's the absence of stress and disturbance, tension or conflict. It's the end of confusion and chaos like we're experiencing right now in America. America has never been so divided. But when we speak peace, the peace that passes all understanding comes from us through God, from God through Christ. He is our peace, who has given us peace with God. And when you have peace with God, then you'll have the peace of God, peace with others. Peace I leave you, Jesus said. Peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Peace. What a word to speak. On the end of all of my letters is the word peace. Everything that makes for your highest good. That's what I wish for you. That's what I speak into your life. Peace in the name of Jesus. The name of God, the name of Jesus, represents his total nature and character. The priests were told, and so are we, put my name on the people and I will bless them. It's a guarantee that God will do what he says he will do. When we speak blessing into the lives of others, we are doing a godlike work in the world. And we're expecting God to do what God says he will do for them. God bless you. Thank you.
His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Father in heaven, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Lord, for waking us up this morning. We thank you for starting us out on another day's journey. Now, Heavenly Father, we're asking you, Heavenly Father, to go with this women's conference this week. Be everything that we need, Heavenly Father. Bless the speakers, Heavenly Father, going to bring your word to us. Help us, Heavenly Father, to understand it, and help us, Heavenly Father, to continue to do your will. And now, Lord, we're asking you to go with the sick and everywhere that we're doing bound to pray for. Go with the church, Heavenly Father. go with Zion, Heavenly Father, each auxiliary, and Father, go with our pastor, Heavenly Father, and go with us, Heavenly Father, as we find new ways of trying to carry on your message in this world. And these and all other blessings, Heavenly Father, that we ask in your name. Amen.
Ladies, Satan ain't got nothing on this technology team here at Zion Missionary Baptist Church. What I need you to do right now is to find the reaction button on your monitor and give a hand clap to this hardworking team for finding a way to keep us going. Praise the Lord. I want to thank Dr. Hale for that wonderful message this morning. Speak life and speak it abundantly. I want to thank our women's voices of praise, our Mother's Prayer Ministry, our guest soloist, Psalmist Karen Thomas, for the words that were provided and the song that enriched our souls. Was it not something? I also want to thank you, our audience, who stuck in there and continued to pour prayer and blessings over us. Oh, what a time. So now I just have a couple of announcements. The first announcement is that this beautiful bag full of items, we're going to bless someone with this. And that person happens to be the first person that commented as we opened up this section this morning. And her name is Sister Celeste Belcher. There's some lovely things in this bag. There's a scripture scarf, and there's a devotional for next year and a little prayer box. But in addition to that, she will get her own copy of Dr. Hill's first book, I'm a Piece of Work. So thank you, Sister Celeste Belcher. Now, we're going to get ready to break for your brunch or your lunch or whomever, if you're having a late lunch, a late breakfast. So stretch and move and quickly check on your families. Stay logged in, stay connected. We will stay on time. So ladies, I know the time is short, but you do not want to miss the vendor pitch. We will start promptly at 11:30 a.m. We will start promptly. So thank you so much for joining us this morning, and we will see you back here in a few minutes.
Say bless, say
bless,
say bless, yeah! In my heart, oh.
many storms have passed your way, and you're all washed out 'cause it rained on your parade. Seems nobody cares about you anyway. Now you're living your life like a castaway. Search for strength inside, was it all in vain? 'Cause the deeper you dig, you find more and more pain. Don't let your tomorrow be like yesterday, 'cause I spoke to God, I called out your name, and on your behalf I just asked if he would be there for you. Never have to live a lie, never have to wonder why, never want for nothing, you're always satisfied in the peace that his arms will provide. He will erase any guilt or shame, any bad habits you got, you won't want to do them again. Yes, we all can change, I can testify. See, I spoke to God, I called out your name, and on your behalf, I just ask if he would be there for you. I want you to be blessed.
Don't live life in
misery. Don't stress out. No, 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 no. He'll work it out. Yes, he will.
CEOs, entrepreneurs, and masters at their craft. So pull your chairs up a little bit closer to the screen, grab a pen and a piece of paper so you can note which products and services you need or just think you need to have. And let me remind you that right in your program, you can find the contact information for each one of these wonderful ladies. So without further ado, come on in, it's time to shop.
Hi, I'm Dr. Candace Walker, owner of Dr. CW Cares and creator of Dr. Yoga Weight Loss, my brand new virtual wellness program. I've spent years practicing medicine in the primary care setting, and this has given me insight. It's shown me an area that needed improvement for overall health and quality of life. That drove me to exploring and practicing an emerging new area called functional medicine. I've experienced the same stress, demands, and life balance issues as you. Join me on this journey based on a systematic approach to identifying the underlying root cause of symptoms and disease based on something that's currently missing in the traditional setting, a therapeutic relationship with a doctor that has the time to focus on you. This new program has four primary areas: diet, movement, lab interpretation, and a customized lifestyle modification plan. As a new venture, I'm inviting a small group of very special clients to help this program mature into one that could help countless others. If you're interested, go join my private Facebook group, Dr. Yoga Weight Loss, today. It's just one of the exclusive benefits you'll receive with being a part of this initial group. In fact, join the group today and you'll get the chance to win a free 30-minute lifestyle planning session with me live and inside of our group. This opportunity is only for the Women of Zion Women's Conference 2020. So go join my private Facebook group, Dr. Yoga Weight Loss, right now, and I'll see you there soon.
Hey guys, it's Bridget, your host for the Entrepreneur Lifestyle Podcast. Listen, I want to invite you personally to join me in the Creative Vibe Studios. Listen, right now, I've got some wonderful training resources just for you. I know it's rough right now because everyone's doing everything all the time. And you're like, how can I do this? How do they have time to make all that happen? I don't even know where to begin. Listen, I got you. And right now, you have to take action, because I can't do it all by myself. I'm here in the Creative Vibe Studios every single day, working and creating and brainstorming and learning and growing, and I want to invite you to join me. No matter where you are, you can come into this studio and find what you need, right? So number one, if you just have a great idea, or maybe you're trying to figure out from a list of five which idea you want to use, start with the Entrepreneur Lifestyle Checklist. This course will help you build your business summary so you can have a clear outline, and maybe you have four summaries, and then you can pick and choose how do you develop those ideas. And then in the BYOB online course, you can develop those ideas individually or see how they come together. You never know what's going to develop until you start working on it. The BYOB online course will help you build your business blueprint, which is the clear outline of where you need to go in order to get your website set, right? You can't jump right into design. Everyone comes to me and they're like, hey, I need a logo. I need a website. If you don't have the foundation laid for your business, you are not ready for design. And I just want to tell you that because I know it's pretty and it's the fun part, but you have to build the foundation first. And that's why you have to come on in here in the Creative Vibes Training Studios to take advantage of all of the resources I have to help you get to that point. So the Entrepreneur Checklist is first, BYOB online course, and then I've created a little snack for you. It's called a simple website recipe. It's not difficult, guys. It's not expensive, and you can do it on your own. It's so easy. I have been helping so many people over the last couple of years really hone in their ideas, start developing their processes, and putting their businesses out there. And you can do it too. And if you need a little help, I have a whole membership, a tribe full of people just like you who are here working and growing. Listen, we're all in this together. We're trying to figure things out every single day. And you better bet, as soon as I learn something, you guys are going to know it too. And it's up to you to take advantage of those trainings in order to get to the next level. And don't worry, if you're not really an entrepreneur and you don't really want to start a business, you're happy where you are, that's perfect. But I have something for you too. I have the Mindset Makeover. Now, we all are human beings. We are all here struggling to defeat distractions and make progress and be productive every single day. And it's all about a mindset shift. Let me tell you, if you can't get your mindset, you can't be a good wife or husband or friend or parent. You can't. So it starts with the mindset first, and then you can jump into the Entrepreneur Checklist and the BYOB course, right? Because if you don't have your mindset prepared for the work you need to do, the distractions you need to avoid, and being able to just control your emotions, key, right? You have to have all these things, not mastered, but at least have some control over it, right? It's a whole makeover. So get in here, let me know how I can help you. Please reach out because I'm excited and I've got some great things on the way for you. This next quarter is gonna blow your mind. I have 2 planners and 1 book. I have a whole book called Created to Win. And I put my journey in here. I've got the mindset makeover. I've got the BYOB outline so that you can take the book and put it to work in your life. And then if you're feeling fancy, you can use the planners to take the course. So listen, just join me here. It's all explained inside creativevibes.com. And I'm here waiting for you. I'm here every day looking for friends to join me on this journey so that we can change our lifestyles and become the best versions of ourselves, because it's time to be the CEO of your life. And I'm here waiting for you. Talk to you soon.
Hi everyone, my name is Romney Smith. I am the chief creator and CEO of Pink Poppy Calligraphy, and I launched it purely by accident. It happened because when I got engaged in 2018, I decided I want calligraphy for my wedding invitation envelopes. Couldn't afford it, so I decided to take a class and learn how to do it myself. From there, I started getting friends and family members asking me to do envelopes for birthday parties, for special events, and even for their own weddings. So it's something that I've thoroughly enjoyed learning how to do over the years. It's certainly a nice creative outlet, but I also discovered something quite interesting during the process, and that's I actually like acrylic signage more than doing calligraphy envelopes. And you might be wondering, when would I use acrylic signage? Well, I have done it for sorority members to have as home decoration. I have done it for geographic pride, breast cancer survivors. There are so many different things you could use it for, including custom quotes that you might want. But the biggest thing I use it for is wedding signage. And this could also go for events. So say a 50th birthday party or a 1-year-old's birthday party to mark how tall they are, their favorite snack, their weight, their favorite thing to do. But wedding signage is where I get a lot of my initial business from. And that includes table numbers, special signage just to welcome guests with their custom wedding colors. That's really what I have a lot of fun with. And so I'd absolutely love if you have an event. If you keep me in mind, you can find me on Instagram at Pink Poppy Calligraphy. I'm also on Etsy on the same name, Pink Poppy Calligraphy. I'm trying to add more things to it. If you'd like to contact me through email, my email is pinkpoppycalligraphy@gmail.com. That's PINKPOPPYCALLIGRAPHY. That's a mouthful, @gmail.com. I am working on building a simple website that will hopefully launch by the end of this year. And so that's probably the easiest way to reach me. I certainly appreciate your time and attention. And if you ever have a special birthday, a special event, or if you're home from working from home and you want some easy, simple decor, my pieces are, the small ones, are about $20 each, and I'd be happy to work with you. Of course, custom quotes, and the more complicated it is, the price does go up. But you know how to contact me through email, through Instagram, which is where you can see a lot more of my work. I look forward to potentially working with you, and I hope you ladies have a wonderful time at your conference.
How y'all doing this evening? How y'all doing this evening?
Caring, creative, and spiritually motivated, I am living my dreams and I'm daring you to do the same. Using faith to propel me forward, I am led by God to win the ultimate prize. I'm small in stature, but my belief runs deep. It can't be measured by man, you see. Enriching women's lives is what I do. Empowering confidence with love too. Standing on faith every step of the way as I earn this Cadillac and park it in my driveway. Loving, living life with all my heart. I am that girl, senior independent beauty consultant, Tiffany Everhart. Thank you for having me today, and thank you for inviting me to share some of my talents with you. I'm a graduate of the University of Tennessee, Chattanooga, where I earned a Bachelor of Science degree in art education. I'm also a graduate of Savannah College of Art and Design, where I earned a master's degree in interior design. I'm from Rome, but I currently reside in Roswell, Georgia, where I get to meet amazing women just like you. Women who are daring, caring, and take care of others before they take care of themselves. But I'm here today to ask you to please take care of yourself. See, as a Mary Kay independent beauty consultant, my job is to make you feel gorgeous. My job is to give you confidence. And so I want to build a relationship with you, not a one-time relationship, a lasting relationship. I want to get to know you. I'm going to sit down with you and I'm going to have an individual consultation with you so that we can understand what your needs are. I started my Mary Kay business 9 years ago to earn extra cash for my own fashion and beauty needs. But today, I've gotten so much more. I've gotten girlfriend time and the flexibility I needed. I'm asking you to get to know me because without me, you don't get any products. But with me, you get products that'll make you look in the mirror and say, who is that girl? All right. So, register on my website and I will call you. I will call you and schedule an appointment with you so we can talk one-on-one and I can get to know you and build a skincare system that fits you. When you purchase from me, I want you to know that you are helping a bunch of women that you don't even know. See, Mary Kay is more than a lipstick. This company pours so much into cancer research and ending the fight against domestic violence. Two causes that are so near and dear to my heart. So, when you purchase from me, you are helping a woman with a child or a woman by herself find safety and shelter that she may not have found without Mary Kay. This weekend, I want to share my love for the company and my love for the products with you. I want you to go on my website and register whether you live in town or out of town. I'm giving away to 5 lucky winners something out of my pink beauty bag. So you don't want to miss this prize and you don't want to miss the opportunity to say, who is that girl? Looking forward to meeting you and working with you. But remember, if you already have a beauty consultant, please do not register on my website. Instead, contact your amazing beauty consultant for her customer service and her best gifts. Can't wait to see you and talk with you. Have a great day.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Era Vista Planner booth. My name is Grace Jempe, and I'm the founder and creator of Voila, the Era Vista Planner. So welcome. Thank you for coming. You might be asking yourself, well, how, young lady, is your planner different? Well, that's because this is not just a planner. It's a lifestyle architect. If you are someone who is looking to elevate, map out your goals, actually get accountability, the Era Vista Planner is for you. So the Era Vista Planner was launched in 2019. For the year we're in 2020, and what you have in here is a world of just information and support. Oftentimes we have a lot of dreams, but they stay that way. It's important for you to actually take your dream, break it down into concrete, measurable action items, and then implement it. And that is what is encompassed here in this planner. It comes in 3 different colors. We have our violet purple. We have our cobalt blue. Forgive the sound. And we have our berry pink. So depending on your personality, we have the berry pink that is for those who want to make a splash. We have the cobalt blue for those who like to keep it calm, cool, and collected. And we have the violet purple for those who like to keep it a bit more regal. So if you wanted to take a look at what's inside, obviously you should definitely get it. But I'll show you a sneak peek. This is what your opening month landing page looks like. It's trying to get away from me. And what I've done is I've categorized what your goals are, because before you even begin working in your planner, you do have a vision setting and goal setting component, which you need to get the planner, again, I say, to actually get the information. But this is what your opening page looks like. Your calendar looks just like this every single month. And this is what your weekly spread looks like. So you have open space to write notes, And then you have a to-do list. You can place appointments there or whatever have you. And then you have reflection space at the end of every single month. Voila. And you also have a camouflage pocket because a girl needs pockets. So if you are interested in the AeroVisa Planner, thank you for listening. Head on over to www.aerovisaplanner.com or go to Instagram and you can follow us at AeroVisa Planner. All the information is there. Again, it's www.aerovisa, A-R-R-I-V-I-S-T-A, planner, common spelling, .com. Thanks for listening.
Hello, ladies. I am Tamara Boggs, the creative in the creative box. I'm a visual artist that works in various mediums, including oil and acrylic paint, pencil and charcoal, as well as what I'm showcasing today. This is bling artistry. I take simple everyday items and I make them pop. This is a Starbucks tumbler. It's very plain. As you can see, I have individually hand-placed high-quality glass stones all the way around this cup. The Starbucks siren is blinged out, and when I turn the cup around, I have personalized it in my name. This is the perfect gift for someone who has everything. If you've got an after five event, or a night on the town, take these dancing. These are blinged out heels and they complement everyone's wardrobe. These will definitely turn heads. You can see the iridescent rainbow light bouncing off of these shoes. And if you like a little bit more comfort, I also do athletic shoes as well as sneakers. And if you want to step it up and sip in style, this wine tumbler is just for you. It has intricate artwork detail of the flower, as well as a positive saying on the back. You can drink in style. And for those who are a little bit more sporty and casual, take it up a notch, add a little flash, with this cap. I customize with any organization, brand, or company. And if you're going to the gym, this is the perfect item to motivate you. Blinged out headphones. You'll certainly knock them dead. For those of you who are into your perfumes, keep your perfumes in this piece of artwork. Put it on your dresser, and before you go out, dab a little so that you are smelling good all night long. And for those special occasions, such as weddings, birthdays, anniversaries, and even New Year's Eve, sip and toast with this elegant blinged out champagne flute. Add a charm to be bold. And for those who aren't into the bling and want something a little bit more subtle, try out pearls. These are classic and I can do designs just as I've done here. Thank you for taking the time to visit me. If you're interested in any of these or want to purchase a customized gift, please check me out on my social media at The Creative Boggs on Facebook and Instagram. Thank you.
Hi, welcome to TL Dubs Treasure Box. My name is Terry Pringle, and I'm an independent consultant for Paparazzi Accessories, and I sell $5 jewelry. You heard it right, $5 jewelry. We do have an exclusive line that is called the Z Collection, and those pieces are $25. But let me tell you, all of our jewelry is nickel and lead free and exquisitely made. $5, you can't go wrong. Let me show you. Here is a set. It's a necklace and earrings because all of our necklaces come with the earrings. $5, y'all, look at that. Let me show you another. Look at this set right here. Isn't this gorgeous? Silver and the stone picks up any color you're wearing. Isn't this gorgeous? And it comes with these gorgeous earrings. $5. We sell gorgeous pearl earrings. Look at here. Tapered all the way down to the smallest dot of a pearl at the end. $5. Look at these earrings. Aren't they gorgeous? All the way to the back. Same. These acrylic earrings. $5. Here's a set. Silver with these blue and white stones. Fish hook backing. $5. We even sell hair accessories. Look at this one. This is a hair clip that is encrusted in pearls. $5, y'all. Isn't that gorgeous? Now, I told you that we also have an exclusive Z collection. Let me show you one of those. It comes with the earrings, like I said. These are $25. But look, you are draped in pearls. Look at that. All the way down. Gorgeous. Pearls and a little bit of bling. All this set is $25. Now, if you're interested in possibly making a little bit of money, some side pocket money, or you want to go bigger and you want to replace your income, you can do that with this business. It's all up to you. If you're interested, one thing I know COVID has shown us is that we do need to have a second stream of income. And what's better than to do it from your own home? You don't even have to leave. All your investment would be is $99 plus tax. If you're interested in joining my team, and I have a team here at Zion, if you would like to join us in spreading some joy with women and men, you can just click on my website and ask join. Or you can email me if you need some more information, and my email is tldub8863@gmail.com. We're open 24/7, and my website is www.tldubtreasurebox.com. That's tldubbtreasurebox.com. We would love to have you join us. If not, you can shop till you drop 24/7 from the comfort of your bed. TL Dubs Treasure Box. Thank you for joining, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.
Hi, my name is Gabby Simone, owner of PrettyUniqueThings.store, and my online boutique has all of your modest, modern-day apparel. We have everything varying from dresses to inspirational tees, these nice fedoras, accessories, a nice denim collection, and more. If you're looking for after five attire or your Sunday morning's best, guess what? This is the boutique for you. And right now, come close. Those of you that are watching, I have a special discount code just for you. Type in modern ship and you will get 10% off of your purchase plus free shipping. 10% off of your purchase plus free shipping. Please don't be afraid to come shop with us at prettyuniquethings.store.
I'm Patasha Peterson, creator and founder of KPRG7 with the mission to enhance your beauty, specializing in makeup application. I'm also a beauty consultant, along with being a lash technician. Also, you can find all my information on KPRG7. That's on Instagram. You can find me on Facebook as Katasha Peterson. You can also review some of my work and my resume on www.kprg7.com, where you can see all my work and my service. You can also book your appointment there as well. I just want to thank you all so much for taking the time to review this video with me. I hope to get your service soon. And one last thing for my wonderful ladies and for my men. If you ever want to get rid of those dark circles around your eyes or dark spots on your face, always soak your cotton ball in some witch hazel and just dab it on your face, and you can see results within maybe 2 to 3 weeks. Thank you. You all have a blessed day. Bye-bye.
Hello. My name is Courtney Sykes, and I'm the founder and creator of Lula's Candle Company. Lula's Candle Company was created during a time where I experienced grief and pain after losing my mom's godmother, the woman who my grandmother considered a best friend, and the woman that I called my Auntie Lula. She passed away from her battle with cancer in January of 2018. And honestly, I had a really tough time dealing with that loss, and I began to find ways to implement self-care and deal with my own anxiety and depression during that time, and fell in love with pouring candles, essentially. She actually taught me how to use my hands as a young child through arts and crafts, and I find myself going back to that during this time of healing. And I really just wanted to do something that honored her, to thank her for the woman that I know that she wanted me to become, but also support families and individuals who are still battling with cancer. So that's a big part of my company, being able to give back a portion of the proceeds to people who are still dealing with this disease. At the end of the day, I'm tired of cancer. I'm tired of it affecting the people that I love. And unfortunately, everyone knows someone that knows someone who has dealt with cancer, whether it's a loved one, a family, a friend, or a close acquaintance. So I hand pour with love out of my home these candles to promote self-care, to promote healing, to promote love and peace. We only use all natural soy flakes. These are some of the soy flakes I'm getting ready to pour and use today. And we also only use phthalate-free fragrance oils. So nothing that's non-toxic, nothing that's toxic and harmful for you. These are chemical-free, clean scents, which are good for you, your family, and your health overall. Not anything that would harm you. So in addition to candles, such as these tins here, I also provide larger candles in glass jars, as well as room sprays that you can use in your bathroom, in your car, wherever you want to freshen up the space.
Greetings. I'm Amanda, owner and formulator here at Bay of Bath Tree Natural Resources. My mission and gift is to provide natural botanical medicine for the whole person. body, skin, hair, and spirit. I formulate with active and clean ingredients using antioxidants, healing botanicals, and nourishing oils, as well as science. Let me introduce a few items from my current line of products.
AAA antiseptic, antiviral, antifungal, moisturizing hand sanitizing gel. 70% alcohol is a powerful cleanser that delivers strong cleansing action for hands while also moisturizing kills organisms by denaturing their proteins and dissolving their lipids, and is effective against most bacteria, fungi, and many viruses. Uber Healing Shea Butter Cream. Anti-aging, antioxidant, anti-inflammatory. This AAA threat shea butter cream combines carrageenan oil, neem oil, black cumin oil, and turmeric combined with herbal power for a large dose of healing. Heal thyself. Superfood Saka Inky Skin Balancing Cream. Restore balance, renew and regenerate your skin with life-giving chlorophyll from wheatgrass, spirulina, and chlorella. High in antioxidants, rich in vitamin A, C, E, and K, boosting the complexion of your skin by delivering oxygen to the cells. Give yourself a dose of youthful glow with green power. Fresh fig and green tea hydrating toner. This fast-absorbing, nutrient-rich hydrating toner leaves the skin feeling clean and refreshed. Your skin tone will be more brightened and radiant from the hyaluronic acid, kombucha culture, vitamin B3, and hydrolyzed silk, while improving your skin's barrier function and reducing water loss and boosting healing. Skin Revival Treatment Oil with Coenzyme Q10. This concentrated source of antioxidants, fatty acids, and nutrients helps to protect the skin against abuse of environmental elements and to nourish and improve the skin texture, rich in minerals, vitamin A, B1, B2, D and E, and beta carotene, revives, replenishes, restores. Glorious Body Oil. Bring out your soft side, be transformed by the renewing of your mind and spirit. This wonder oil is intensely nutritionally rich with cucumber oil, kiwi seed oil, watermelon seed oil, and apple seed oil, with comfrey extract, aloe extract, and licorice extract. With a combined vitamin E, coenzyme Q10, and ascorbyl palmitate, which is the vitamin C, all that combined increases the antioxidant effect, improves appearance of aged skin, and corrects hyperpigmentation. Pure Gold Moisturizing Cream, decadent, buttery, nourishing. Envelope yourself in a warm, sweet, balsamic essence, while shea butter restores elasticity, reduces inflammation, and moisturizes dry skin. Elderberry Asharoot Complex. This herbal blend, especially during this time of COVID, helpful in deactivating the influenza virus, stimulates immune system, and prevents secondary infections, taken in early stages of flu or cold to prevent symptoms from taking hold. Head covering, conditioning, and nourishing hair oil. Your hair is given to you as a covering. Anoint yourself, and may healthy and long hair be your glory. This rich and luxuriant hair oil works from your scalp to the ends of your hair to moisturize, nourish, and condition while softening and detangling for noticeable silkiness. Luminous Cleansing Body Polish. This deeply cleansing and exfoliating skin polish with extra fine volcanic pumice, shea butter, and fruit sugar extract to hydrate for supremely soft, luminous skin. With the warm and decadent aroma of dark chocolate and a penetrating green, herbaceous scent of sweet basil, your bathing ritual will leave you clear-minded and uplifted.
drink.
Text your people, they shit. All the problems and your needs if you just lawyer, doctor, anything if you just. You got some questions about some things you just. You a king, be the king, you just. Got proper comfort for the queens if they live if ever see the dream. Get your phone, text your people, they shit. Feel you're in the shadows by yourself. You just underwater and not reaching out for help. Whoa, only wave you can't get over is your own. That tsunami blocking passage to the throne. Phone dying, worry how you getting home. Preparation isolated and alone. Pull up like a Uber, hallelujah. Any type of music that'll move you. And we don't really care what you're doing, we just walk up in the room like. Text your people, they should ask Christ. All the problems and your needs if you just ask Christ. Lawyer, doctor, anything if you just ask Christ. You got some questions about some things, you just ask Christ. You a king, he the king, you just ask Christ. A proper comfort for the queens if they ask nice. Live if ever see the dream if you ask Christ. Get your phone, text your people, they should ask Christ. You're in the shadows by yourself. You just underwater and not reaching out for help. Whoa, only wave you can't get over is your own. That tsunami blocking passage to the throne. Phone dying, worry how you getting home. Preparation isolated and alone. Pull up like a Uber, hallelujah. Any type of music that'll move you. And we don't really care what you're doing, we just walk up in the room like.
Is anybody in here blessed?
I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Feel you're in the shadows by yourself. You just underwater and not reaching out for help. Whoa, only wave you can't get over is your own. That tsunami blocking passage to the throne. Phone dying, worry how you getting home. Preparation isolated and alone. Pull up like a Uber, hallelujah. Any type of music that'll move you. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Since wishes make you feel like less. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed.
God is good, it's true, just like the statement. Look, the sky's blue.
Seeing how God was just moving in my life, connecting me with the right people that would push me into purpose. And so I said, God, why does this keep happening to me? So I was riding in the car, and I was looking at some homes. I said, one day I want a house like that. And the Lord just kept, he kept showing me series and sequence of events that were just flashing through my mind. And I started crying and I became overwhelmed. This keeps happening to me. It keeps happening for me. And I was in the car by myself, and I said, God, I thank you. I won't complain. I'll trust you. So I started, the lyrics just started coming to me. And I said, my seed is blessed. My money is blessed. My body is blessed. but cover our family. I'm covering my family. I'm making better decisions. Destroying every addiction. Your hands and go with me here and I say, I accept your blessing. I trust you with my future. Cause your way of life, come on, sing it, is the best thing for me. We're just gonna go here and let's just take it all the way in and let's worship him. Sing it like you mean it.
My money is blessed.
Sing it like you mean it, it's easy.
Making better decisions.
Destroying every addiction. It keeps happening for me. I won't apologize. No more feelings.
Welcome back, ladies. I hope that you had a chance to grab a quick bite. We are getting prepared for our afternoon breakout sessions. For your information, in order to get to your breakout sessions, you will need to push yourself into your session. So at the bottom of your screen or your monitor, you will see a new icon that says, join your breakout session. You will need to click on that icon and you'll see the list of breakout sessions for session number one. There will be three. And right next to each one, there is a join button that you can click and it will place you right into your session. So again, at the bottom of your screen, along with the other icons, see your new button for breakout sessions. Click on that button. It will bring up the three sessions. Click the word join next to your session and you will automatically be entered into your session. Thank you.
Hi guys, my name is Jasmine Stewart. I'm 15 years old, I'm from Milton, Georgia, and I'm a proud member of Zion Missionary Baptist Church. And today I'm so excited to tell you a little bit about my company, Just Jazz LLC. Now you may recognize me from winning season 5 of the show MasterChef Junior, and that was an incredible opportunity and I'm so grateful to Zion for always supporting me. But one huge thing that my parents always told me is that if you have a platform, use it for good. So when I was thinking about things that really affected young girls like me, it was insecurity and always trying to find a need for validation, always trying to fit in. And I wanted to do something about it. So I created the slogan, Let Your Inner Girl Slay. Now, Let Your Inner Girl Slay means whoever you truly are on the inside, let her out, let her be unapologetic and slay. Now, don't let the girl who you think everybody wants you to be slay. Don't be the girl who you feel like you need to be to impress people. Be the girl who you truly are and let her slay. Be who you truly are on the inside. So that was the first thing I did. But the second thing I did, bouncing off of my slogan, Let Your Inner Girl Slay, was my newest product, which I'm so excited to show you guys, my girl bags. Now you may be wondering, is this a purse? Is this a wallet? Is this a tote bag? No, it is a girl bag. This is a whole new category, guys. So a girl bag is a bag for all things girls. It's a bag specifically crafted to hold things for girls and to also inspire girls on a daily basis when you look at the bag. Now, you're probably seeing that the bag comes in two colors, and trust me, that was very intentional. This first bag is called the Dream Girl Bag, and it's called Dream because it's pink and it's a very vivid color. And I want to inspire girls to recognize, let your dreams be vivid and colorful and bright. Don't let your dreams be dull, and don't doubt the power of God. Make sure that you remember that God can take your dreams anywhere, and let your dreams be colorful and vivid. This next bag is called the Act Bag, and I made it white because I believe that life is a blank canvas and it's up to you to paint your story. It's going to take a little bit of hard work and you might have some challenges, but as long as you stay faithful and you paint your story, you're going to be good. So we have our Dream Bag and our Act Bag. Now let's get into a little bit more of the technical side of the bags. So when you get your girl bag, it's going to come with a really cute latch on the side that says, let your inner girl slay. Trust me, I'm going to remind you all the time to let your inner girl slay. Then it has two zippers, and if you can see, the bag opens like so. And I like that it opens like this just because it really allows you to fit things in, and the circular shape really works when you're putting your products inside the bag. So it comes with two webs on the side to help keep your products in, and as you can see, it opens pretty wide. Now, when you look on the inside, once again, you're going to see Let Your Inner Girl Slay. I'm telling you, I'm going to keep reminding you guys that. But I honestly love that because every single time I reach into my girl bag, I always see this, and it inspires me to let my inner girl slay for the day. So as you can see, we have specific pockets made for girls. When we were making the bag, we tested it to make sure it can hold everything that a girl needs, feminine products, and even cosmetic products, and whatever you can imagine. So we have our pockets here with the elastics on them, and then we also have a pocket here with the zipper on it that can fit some pretty cool stuff in there. And if you have light messes or light spills, you can always wipe that outside of the bag. So that is the technical part of the bag. If you want to order the girl bag, which I would be so grateful if you wanted to, you can visit my website, www.justchefjasmine.com. Once again, www.justchefjasmine.com. And you can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at Just Chef Jasmine. Thank you guys so much for listening to me. I hope that you order a girl bag, and I hope that you love it. And always remember to let your inner girl slay. Hi guys, my name is Jasmine.
Hi, and welcome to Levette Lock Studio. My name is Jasmine Levette Barton, and I am a certified Sister Locks consultant. I use only your natural hair to create small, medium, or micro-sized locks, like so. And it helps keep your hair healthy. It helps it to retain length. And if you ask me, Sister Locks is the best hair decision ever.
Levette Lock Studio is a small home-based business. I want to give you a glimpse into my client's experience. I have a room separate from my personal home space, and I chose to do it in my home to provide my clients with a more intimate setting. My natural hair care services are by appointment only. I make sure to schedule everyone with enough time so that no one runs into anyone or ever have to worry about waiting before they are serviced. I like to keep plants and flowers just to have some life in the room, symbolizing that when you choose Sister Locks, you are choosing to take care of your hair like you would take care of your plants, water them, feed them nutrients, and they will continue to grow long, strong, and healthy. For more information on Sister Lock services, please visit LevetteLockStudio.com and follow me on Instagram at Levette_Locks.
I am very grateful and blessed to have two prospering new businesses. I am a self-published children's book author, and I am so excited to share with you today my two children's books.
Saying No Doesn't Mean Never was written when my son Maxwell was 3 years old. He would cry hysterically every time I told him no. I realized that there was times when I just had to use the word no, and I needed him not to always respond negatively. Have you ever been there? Have you ever had anxiety before having to tell your child no? Does your child have tantrums and screaming fits when they don't always get their way? Do you want to teach your child patience? If so, this book is for you. Ace Wins the Race with Dad's Amazing Grace was written when Maxwell was 5 years old. My husband and I have been spending some time teaching him how to ride his bike without training wheels, and this was not an easy process at all. He struggled. He didn't always trust the process, but when he finally got it, he asked me if we could write a book to teach other children. Oh, and that was exciting. I interviewed him to get some ideas about what he wanted in the book, and we created a masterpiece. And it rhymes. You can purchase these books on Amazon.com or my personal website, LevetteLockStudio.com. Thank you for your love and support.
Father, creator of heaven and earth, we come to your throne of grace with thanksgiving for the gift of life you bestow upon us today. We thank you for the gift of Jesus Christ, your Son and our Redeemer. And we praise you for your spoken blessings throughout the Holy Scriptures. Dear Jesus, we shout hallelujah for your Sermon on the Mount as you proclaimed, "Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." During these perilous times, we, your servants, seek your blessings and your protection because persecutions have rained down on us time and time again. However, as we go through trials and tribulations, we are reminded of God's promise when he stated, "Never will I leave you, never will I forsake you." And we remember Jesus on Calvary as he proclaimed, "Today, you will be with me in paradise." There is power in spoken blessings. And because of that truth, we pray in faith, we walk in faith, and we trust in your testaments. Thank you, Jesus, for your shed blood on Calvary. We are blessed through that blood. There is power in that blood, and praise God, there is salvation in that blood. Lord, we know that you will be in the midst of our service tomorrow, and we pray that you will spiritually feed us till we want no more. Dear Jesus, continue to anoint our pastor, Reverend James, with wisdom and humility as he shepherds this flock called Zion. Amen.
Ladies, the truth of God's word has been shared with you in ways that speak across generations. I know that some of you may have been challenged with the time and giving us so much of your time today, but I know that God has been in the midst so that we are all blessed in some way today, that we may go out, and I implore you to go out to bless someone else. I thank God for all that he has given us. I want to thank everyone that has helped us with putting on this weekend event. I hope that it was well worth your time. I'm not going to keep you, but I do want to tell you one more thing. And that is, I would love for you to join us tomorrow for our Sunday women's worship service. We have a dynamic speaker, the Reverend Allison Henderson Brooks. We have our first ever virtual women's choir. And so we would just love to have you join us at 10:45 a.m. With that, now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before his presence with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power forever and ever. Amen. Good night, ladies.
For your name is worthy to be lifted up. Lord, we love your name. We bless your name. For your name is worthy to be lifted up.
Lord, we love your name. We bless your name.
For your name.
Oh, Lord, we love.
Lord, we love your name. We bless your name.
Yeah.
Your name is worthy to be lifted up.
Lord, we love your name. We bless
your
name.
That's it. It's real simple.